So they finally, after a couple of months of submitting ideas to them, they finally said, well, we think you have enough stories here to go ahead and start, to come in and meet with us and talk about a script. So I went into the Seinfeld offices, and I was a really big fan of this show, and I was really nervous. And it was a rainy day, and I couldn't find a parking spot, and I finally showed up. And I met with Larry and Jerry for the first time. Larry David was running the show with Jerry. So Jerry was not just an actor, but he was also a writer and very involved in the day-to-day production of the show. And I went through this outline of the script that I was going to write. And they seemed to like it. And Larry David turned to me and said, well, I want you to write this script. And I had never done a half-hour script before, so I didn't know that that meant that I had a job. So I thought that that just meant that he was sort of rooting for me, and that he had to talk to a lot of other people. Like, he had to talk to the network and say, hey, we got this guy, Andy Robin, who wants to write a script. Here's what his idea is. So I went home thinking, well, that was a pretty good meeting. Larry David is on my side. He's like rooting for me. And I'm just waiting for the next step. I'm just sitting at home waiting for the phone to ring. And then it finally rings a few days later, and my agent, who's a guy who helps you get work, he said, hey, why didn't you tell me you got the script assignment? And I said, well, I didn't. They're thinking about it. And he said, no, they gave you the script. You got the assignment. And I said, well, no, Larry just said he wants me to do the script. He said, that means you got the script. And he said, well, if you do it, you do it. So the reason I'm telling you guys this story is because when you're working for a TV show, you're so desperate for a funny story that you start thinking about things from your own life that amused you. And that story eventually, I used that story in a different episode. In an episode called The Barber. George goes for a job interview, and the guy he interviews with tells him he wants him to have the job, and then he's sort of interrupted by a telephone call. So George never knows whether or not he got the job. So, because people often ask, well, where do you get these story ideas? And the answer is sometimes they're just silly, weird things that just come to you suddenly, but a lot of times they're things from your real life. Like, writing scripts, as you can tell if you look through these things, is pretty different from writing prose. You have to think about how people talk. And people usually don't talk in a very clear, precise way. There are a lot of ums and uhs and false starts and tentative ideas that like get pulled back. And so that's something that some people have. It's something I had to kind of work on. But like anything, if you guys are interested in writing scripts for TV or movies or YouTube or just for fun, the best thing to do is just to practice doing it and to run it by friends and see what they think and just do a lot of versions of it until you're happy with it. And just listen to it over and over until it sounds real to you. Sometimes scripts intentionally don't sound very real. They're kind of stylized. Like there was a show, The West Wing, on TV. It felt, to my ear, it felt a little bit sort of fake, but it was still fun to watch. And some shows are very realistic and have a lot of, they like let the actors, they'll just tell the actors what the basic idea behind the scene is, and then they'll let the actors improvise the lines. And that can feel very natural because the actors will have a lot of stops and ums and uhs and things like that. So I want to pass around this scene. So this show we're about to watch is The Jimmy, and one of the stories in this episode is about a character who refers to himself in the third person. So instead of saying, I played a really great basketball game today, this character says, Jimmy had a great game today. And this is something that came to me because a lot of athletes and musicians and a lot of sort of pompous people will refer to themselves by their own name. And I just had this idea that it would be funny if the character is talking about himself and saying, Jimmy's doing this and Jimmy's doing that, and if the Seinfeld character, Elaine, thinks that he's talking about somebody else.